In this video, we're introducing Coulomb's law, describing the force between two electrical charges, and then we're going to apply Coulomb's law to two examples. As a starting point, I wanted to remind you of the direction of force between two charges. So over here on the left, we see that if we have two positive charges, they repel each other. If we have two negative charges, they also repel each other. And when the signs are different, they attract each other. So there's the directionality of the force between the charges. But what about the magnitude of the force? Well, I think this makes a lot of sense, that the closer the charges are to each other, the stronger the force between them. So Coulomb's law includes that piece of information, but more specifically, it works like 1 over the distance between the two charges squared. The force between the charges is also proportional to the magnitude of each charge, and then there's a constant K out in front that's equal to 8.99 times 10 to the 9th Newton meter squared per Coulomb squared. I want to make a couple points about Coulomb's law before we apply it. And the first one is that if I put in like charges here, so each one of these is a plus charge, Coulomb's law would give me a positive force. That must mean a repulsive force between the two charges. Now try it with minus signs. If I put in two negative charges, that also comes out positive, giving me a repulsive force. If I put in one positive charge and one negative charge into Coulomb's law, it's going to come out negative, which means an attractive force between the charges. The second point I wanted to make before moving on is to look at the units of K. So it has these odd units of Newton meter squared per Coulomb squared, and I just wanted to check that that makes sense. So when I'm looking at Coulomb's law, on the left-hand side, if I examine the units, I could say the units of force should be equal to the units of K times the units of Q1, units of Q2, over the units of R squared. And so that gives me the units of K times Coulombs, or Coulombs squared, over meters squared. And I know that the units of force are newtons. So newtons have got to be the units of K times Coulombs squared per meters squared. So I could just solve for K real quick and say, well, K better have units of newtons in order to get the newtons popping out on the left-hand side. And then I've got to cancel the meters squared and the Coulomb squared. And that's why K has these odd units. Moving on to a couple examples. First, I'm asked to compute the force between two 1 micro-Coulomb charges separated by 1 meter. So this prefix is read micro, and that means 1 millionth or 10 to the negative 6th. So let's get a picture of our charges. There it is, two 1 micro-Coulomb charges separated by 1 meter. And I plug into Coulomb's law. Just to remind you, K, Q1, Q2 over R squared. And we plug in K. I'm not going to write the units since we already discussed them at length. Both of my charges are the same, so I can just write it like this. Remember, a micro-Coulomb is 10 to the negative 6 Coulombs. So I can just write it as 10 to the negative 6 squared since there's two of them. And then my distance is 1 meter squared. When I crunch the numbers on this, I get 0.00899 newtons of force. In my second example, I want to find the force of attraction between the proton and the electron in a hydrogen atom. And I'm given some useful numbers here. The diameter of hydrogen is about 1 angstrom. That's the A with the little circle over it. And that's 10 to the negative 10th meters. And that means the radius, which is really what I'm interested in because that's the separation distance. The radius is going to be half the diameter, or 0.5 times 10 to the negative 10 meters. I'm also told the elementary charge is 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19th Coulombs. Now that's the charge magnitude on the proton and the electron. The difference is that the electron has a minus sign. So if I write that into my picture, my proton has a charge of plus QE. My electron has a charge of minus QE. So we plug into Coulomb's law. And again, I can streamline things a little bit because my charges have the same magnitude. There is a minus sign out in front, but I have the same magnitude of charge for each one. So I can just write it as 1.6 times 10 to the negative 19 Coulombs all squared. And then the distance between them squared, so 0.5 times 10 to the negative 10 meters, all squared. So this is going to come out negative, indicating that it's an attractive force between these two because they're unlike charges. And when I run the numbers, I get negative 9.21 times 10 to the negative 8th newtons. Again, in Coulomb's law, the minus sign means we're talking about an attractive force. In some versions of this question, you might just be asked for the magnitude of the force, and then you just ignore the minus sign. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.